Hi all, I'm Marco Fessotto. This is my founder ID is Memotex. On my XC I am Memotex as well. Gmail homepage is the same page of the project I'm going to present, which is a music wiki. I have also a deserted IRC channel where nobody ends, but in case I'm there. And a GitHub page where you can download stuff. I would like to mention that my background is humanities, so I'm not really a programmer, but okay. This is a one-man project, so that's from the stats of the contributors, that is just me. Why I started a wiki engine project? Because I needed long-term storage of texts in a clean way. And also I like typography. I wanted to publish these texts giving the best possible reading experience. Of course, this translates to first thing, I have no trust in databases, so the texts themselves are in a flat file storage system, so where one text has exactly one file, which is self-contained. It has the text itself and the metadata. This, of course, can be leveraged to have a Git backend. So the history of the changes in the text can, of course, be tracked down. Why best reading experience? Because, you have PDF exports almost everywhere, but what I mean for high quality output is LaTeX output, so typography, proper typography. And also EPUB output for the e-readers and also mobile devices. Another feature is the book reader, which was stolen, or I don't know, it was which is also MediaWiki providing, where you can choose various articles and then collect them and create a PDF out of them. But with a MediaWiki, you can customize the fonts, dimensions, and so on. And of course, in is a LaTeX output, so the typographical quality is much better. There is also an HTML importer, which was needed because people usually, normal people, not the programmers, stores texts in Word documents or copy and paste from other web pages. So the JavaScript CK editor has a feature which actually you can paste Word documents into a form which fits the engine with the HTML, and from them I can get the clean output. So this is the markup which I use in the wiki. It's called, I call it Amuse because the original, let's call it that, so specification is borrowed from Emacs Muse project. Any Emacs user here? Have you ever heard of the Muse?
Yeah.
Okay. This is the base of the markup. So you can see this is what I meant by self-contained. So this start text, this is of course a heading, this is a bold, italic, of course you can have links, lists, quotations, images, attachments, nested lists, and so on. And here you can have the metadata, and this can store basically anything. You are not bound to these values, so you can store random stuff there. But I think the title, subtitle, author, the topics, dates are the most commonly used. So, let me show you something. This is the standard text view of an unknown page. This is taken from the amuserwiki.org site, and this is the manual. So you have the metadata display above. These are actually links, so they point, of course, to a list of, well, of course, you click on my name, you get the list of my texts, and so this is the same for the topics. These are the download formats. So you have the plain PDF and the two imposed version. Because I wanted to give people the option to download an imposed PDF, where, for example, this is an A4, and on a physical A4 you can find two A5 properly sorted, so they can just print recto and verso, fold the clip, and you have the booklet. For the rest of the world, US, for the EPUB, for the mobile devices, the HTML without the layout, so the so-called printer-friendly HTML, you don't actually need that for printing, but in case. The data source, the source itself in the user format, so it's basically a plain text. A zip file with the sources, because sometimes there are images attached, so you can download the text, the news, and the images. This is the link to the revision control, which I show you in a moment. This is the button for editing, so this will just edit this text. And this is for the book builder, where you can add this is a plus, so you add text to your collection. This is a book builder. Here I have two texts. I can rearrange the layout here, give a text, give it a title for the collection. I have the option to output an EPUB instead of a PDF. Font selection, font dimension, and the list is much longer, but you are welcome to try on amuserwiki.org itself if you are interested. This is an example of an imposed PDF. There are a number of schemas you can choose, so there is not just the booklet form, but you can have more complex schemas. So, for example, in this way you can print an A6 on an A4, for example, and have a nice little booklet. These are the modules I've published on CPEN. Some of them are very specific, because, for example, text and news is the parser for the lightweight markup. This is more generic. This ebook EPUB Lite. It's a port to move off the original ebook EPUB module. I had the blessing of the original out, so I asked, I said to him, I'm going to fork and port it to move. I'd like your blessing. You say, okay, just go on. Okay, thank you. Text and news preprocessor. This is a cleaner, mostly because of the smart quotes feature and to linkify the bare links, basically. But mostly because of the smart quotes, you all know what the smart usually you type the stronger, the soft quotation on the keyboard, and you get the typographical quotes, the Turing quotes. PDF imposition is the probably the most useful for people not interested at all in this stuff because it's generic. It just takes a PDF as input, you specify the schema, and you get back the logical pages properly arranged. And then there is the text and use compile, which does view all together and provides also the command line script. So actually you can use this stuff for just for publishing or for writing your notes, and you, it's totally decoupled of by the from the site. So you don't need a site to just the type set. The web front end, it's a catalyst application. So but there is a reason, because the original implementation of this stuff was in Next. This is the second rewrite, and it is a text. But okay, the layout is a good standard bootstrap layout without too much tweaking. It is a multi-site engine, so on a single instance you can have as many sites as you want. Database with DBMS class. Text search, it supports full text search with Xekia. You all know Xekia? Basically, it's, it is shipped, I think, by default with Debian, because Apt itself uses Xekia. And it's very fast, small, and there are per modules which have a good integration with the engine. So the toolkit, there is nine languages which have the proper localization. And the user management is peer-based. So actually there is no hierarchy between the users. You have the anonymous, there are the robot users which don't need, just need to fetch the files. They are anonymous, which depending of, on the mode in which the site is running, can use the book builder or edit text. And then you have the librarians, which basically can create or modify, special pages. And can approve changes, and they can create peers. So once you have an account, you can create others account with your same level of privilege. There is a root account, but it requires basically shell access, so there is not much Git. So this was the front end. The back end is a daemon, which basically accepts, takes care of all the operations which are expensive or where concurrency is a problem. For example, the LaTeX compilation is not something you want on your machine running at five compilation at the same time, because the machine will just go down. But you have the log, the kind of live log display via IX. In this example, I did some local changes on my machine that I pushed to a remote repository, and from the site I just pulled from them. So here it's pulling the stuff, examining, indexing. Here it found an error, handled it and continued. And the same interface is when you publish text or create a collection of the book. The archive history. This is a CIVIT. You all know CIVIT. This is basically a faster version of the Git web, because this actually do caching, and it's written in C. It's a CGI script which is listening on localhost, and the application actually does a proxying of the request, so it's inserted properly into the layout. As I said, you can run the sites in different modes. You can have a totally private site where just users with an account can view. blog, which is basically only the accounts can edit text. Moderated wiki, where the accounts can create, can approve changes, and anonymous can edit sites, and the open wiki, which is the wild device. I have tests in the application.
What? Because you have tests.
I have tests. And not a small amount. Okay, questions?